Well, several agencies arrived to the scene just moments after the shooting began, including the FBI. And video shows agents running towards the building where they did set up the perimeter. ATF also arrived. They're helping with the investigation. Joining us now in our newsroom, we have more on the investigation. KPIX 5 security analyst Jeff Harp, former assistant special agent in charge of the FBI office in San Francisco. Jeff, good to see you again, but sorry for the circumstances, of course.
Absolutely.
First question, what comes next for these investigators on scene?
Well, everybody's going to want to know the why, and the investigation will take us in that direction. Obviously, it's kind of a three-stage process. You've got the emergency response, the first responders, and from the video that I've seen, you know, unfortunately, we are learning a lot of lessons in all these incidences that are occurring around the country and around the world. Looks like the police got in there fast. They were able to get into the scene. The next thing they'll do is they'll slow that down a little bit. They'll look over the scene, make sure there's no other people involved. And then obviously once it's locked down, the outer perimeter is secure, the inner perimeter is secure, they'll conduct a very methodical search to look for evidence, to look for anything that can lead them to some clues as to what happened and why.
So specifically, the evidence they might be looking for, shell casings, things like that?
Yeah, I mean, all that will be marked and laid out. Evidence response teams will come in. They'll start marking where, you know, the handgun was found, where the shooter was, where the shooter's body was. They'll look at where the victims were sitting. I'm sure they'll ask for YouTube's security cameras so they can review that footage. And again, they'll try to determine how this person got onto the campus, if it was penetrated outside the courtyard area there where the restaurant's at. They're going to look at all that information.
So we've been told that the shooter used a handgun. Are they going to be looking down the road at specifically, okay, how easy was it to get a handgun on the property? How did that possibly happen?
Well, I mean, you got to think back. Right now today, we aren't living in, you know, martial law where we have metal detectors at every single storefront or anything else. And these campuses are open, but most of them do have badge access. And so I'm sure they'll look to make sure that that was, you know, that protocol was in place. It doesn't mean that somebody couldn't tailgate in or somebody couldn't get in otherwise.
Okay, the police did give a press conference a little bit ago. We're going to play a little bit of that for you so you can listen to it. Let's go ahead and listen.
All right.
We had three officers arrive within 2 minutes, so I think we were on scene at 12:48. They entered the building and saw a large number of people fleeing the building. They encountered, as I mentioned in our earlier conference, they identified one victim at the front door, main entrance of the building. They checked on that person, and YouTube employees, to their credit, helped us by standing by with that person so the officers can immediately enter to go search for the threat.
Okay, Jeff, obviously he's talking about the tactics they use, and you had mentioned the officers did get there very, very quickly. I'm not asking you to armchair quarterback here, but give us your interpretation of law enforcement's response here today.
Well, like I said, unfortunately, we've had so many of these things happen in the past, and again, we do get a lot of armchair quarterbacking going on, and it's, you know, you can look at an event after it happens and say we should have done this or could have done that, but when I see today these officers going into the, you know, the tunnel of death, as we call it, you know, they go up the stairs, they immediately go to the sound of the gunfire, which in an active shooter situation is what you're taught to do. I see the employees leaving the building with their hands up or hands on their head. They're being given very specific commands. They're going to go to a holding area where they're going to be searched because they want to make sure that there's not somebody else who has come out that was part of this problem.
You know, we talk so much about security and how much it's increased, of course, at airports and other transportation hubs, and now we're discussing schools and increasing security there. You know, I think high-tech companies are more concerned about cybersecurity than something like this, but do you think now they need to be lumped into this conversation as well in terms of physical security?
Well, they will. I mean, they're going to go back and look at and see what could we have done differently to prevent something like this from happening. Obviously, I don't think anybody's going to install metal detectors at the front door. I think at the end of the day, what you're going to try to do is recognize the signs of problems that may be developing with individuals at work. Workplace violence, prevention is the best thing you can do to prevent something like this from happening.
Absolutely. All right, Jeff Harp, thank you. We do appreciate your time.
Sure.
Okay.